Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we're gonna convert a PowerPoint into a PDF and then make it accessible. But before we get to that, take a minute to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. In a previous video, I made this PowerPoint accessible by using the accessibility checker and walking through the slides manually to ensure that all of the content is correct. Now, I'm going to convert this document over to a PDF and make that accessible. The first step that I want to do is select the Acrobat toolbar. If you don't have the Acrobat toolbar, that means you do not have Adobe Acrobat Pro installed on your computer, and you may have to do a file save as to retain the formatting. Since I have the Acrobat toolbar, I'm going to select Create PDF. We're going to save our document. And now we have this file open in Adobe Acrobat. Let's go ahead and begin making this accessible. The first thing I want to do is open up the tags panel. And the first thing I noticed is a whole bunch of section tags throughout my file. Now, this isn't necessarily a problem, but I personally don't love section tags. The first thing I'm going to do is put everything under a document tab. And to do that, I'm going to right click in the tags panel, select new tag, and type the word document and select OK. Next, I'm going to move all of my tags from the tags tree underneath my document tag. And I'm doing that by using a variety of keyboard shortcuts to select all of the tags, and then I'm dragging them under the document. Now that all of the tags are under the document tag, we can begin to walk the tags panel. Now, there are some excess tags in here, like the section tags and some art tags, but at the end of that, we have our H1 tag. Now, it's important to note that section, art, and part tags are all visual only tags and currently, as of recording of this video, have no impact on assistive technology. With that said, we can either remove them or keep them. I'm going to keep them for right now and let's just see what happens. So let's keep walking through our tags panel. We have an H1 to start. That's awesome. We then have a P tag and let's keep going. Oh, it looks like our reading order is a little bit off on slide 2. But that's okay. I can simply cut my tag and move it to the right location and delete this extra art tag that came through. So now I have H2, list, and a figure tag. And let's go ahead and check the alternate text on this image. And I could do that a couple of different ways. I can actually hover my mouse over the image and I can determine that it says a headshot photo of Sean Jordison. Or I could right click the figure tag, select properties, and view it in the alternate text panel. Now, if we wanted to get really fancy, we actually could change the section tag. I'm pressing F2 to rename the tag, and I can change it to read slide 1, and then we can do similar things to group our content. So sometimes this is useful if you have complicated slides. It will help you as a remediator to keep track of where you are. Sometimes it's a bit of an extra step, but it has come in useful in a variety of occasions for me. All right, and it looks like our links were properly carried over. That's great. Let's go ahead and keep walking the tags panel. We have an H2. We then have paragraph text and a list. H2, list, H2, list. Everything seems to be coming through appropriately. And a big part of this is because I set up my PowerPoint template to be accessible to begin with. So it wasn't a heavy lift to get it over into Adobe Acrobat and be accessible. Let's go ahead and keep walking through this. And all I'm doing right now is just validating that the tags are in here appropriately by walking through all of this content. Now, all of the tags again are nested under art tags, and that's typically because of the formatting I've used to format the font in this document. But so far, everything is looking pretty good. Let's keep walking through H2. We've got list items that are properly formatted, and H2, another list, and so on. I'm skipping a couple of these because it's coming through perfectly. All of our images have alternate text because we did that heavy lifting in PowerPoint, and it looks pretty good. Now, if I wanted to, I could edit some of the headings within this document, but I don't mind that they're heading level 2s because I do give the number at the end of each of the slides. But if I really wanted to, I could artifact these. I don't think it's necessary for this particular presentation, so I'm actually gonna leave them. And yeah, this document looks great. So now my next step, after I've determined that the tags are properly inserted, is let's go ahead and check out the metadata. To do that, I'm going to select File and then Properties. And this is where we can adjust the title, author, subject, and keywords. So the title of this document is going to be an intro to PDF accessibility. Author is Sean Jordison, that's me, the accessibility guy. And then the subject, I like to think of it is like, what would you tell someone this document is about? I would say a presentation on how to make PDFs accessible. And then the keywords, you could customize them or you can copy and paste some of your other content in here. This is a bit subjective. And then we would select okay. Now we're at the point where we can run the accessibility checker. So let's select the accessibility button and then select accessibility check. We want it to scan 32 of 32 categories and select start checking. And it looks like I have just a couple of errors under document. For some reason, the title is failed. This is an easy fix. I can simply right click the title and select fix, and it is now passing. So this document is now accessible within Adobe Acrobat, but let's take it one step further and let's make it WCAG compliant. I'm going to launch the PDF accessibility checker or PAC 2021 tool, and let's drag our file in here and let's see what we can do to make it WCAG compliant. Looks like we have a failure on 1.1 text alternatives. Let's dive into this a little further and see what the actual error is. Alternative descriptions missing for annotations. Okay, so this means that there's a specific fix we need to apply for this. This is the fastest method I know how to fix it. I'm going to go into my pre-flight menu. Let me show you a different method to open that. So if I expand my tools under Optimize PDF, there is an option called pre-flight. And we're going to launch it. And I'm going to select this wrench icon. And this will bring me to individual fixes for Adobe Acrobat. And I'm going to simply type in annotate. And there is an option under interactive elements that says create content entry for link annotations. I'm going to select that option and select fix in the bottom right corner. And then we're going to save our file out one more time. And that should fix this error. Let's bring up the PAC 2021 checker again and drag our file into it. And that did clear the 1.1 error. Next, we have an error under 1.4 distinguishable. Let's go ahead and expand this out and try to find what it is. Aha, it's telling me my contrast for the bullet is not the right color. Well, let's go ahead and test this out. I'm going to open up the color contrast analyzer and let's use the eyedropper tool to select my blue. And it is in fact failing according to this. So what that tells me is I actually need to go back into my PowerPoint file and fix this. Technically, it's a failure under 1.4.11 for UI components and graphical objects. So we would need to go through, select the edit button, and change all of these bullet points. It's probably gonna be faster though if I just do it in my PowerPoint file. So that's the next step I would need to do, is go through my PowerPoint file, which I have open here, and change all of these bullets to a darker. I just wanna test it one more time within PowerPoint. It is failing. So I've got some work to do to take this back and fix these. This is a perfect example to show you that not even I am perfect at this. So I need to go back and adjust that color within PowerPoint, but I hope this video still helps you in making your PDF documents accessible. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert, and I hope to see you in my next video.